The first thing to say about military compass calculations is that everybody who is or has been in the military will already know everything about what I'm going to say today. They're the experts in this topic. I teach civilian navigation for use when finding your way around the hills with a map and a compass. And this video will hopefully give civilians a very basic introduction to this topic. I do have a request for all current and ex-military personnel. If I say anything wrong today, can you let me know in the comments? Thank you. If you've watched any of my other videos, you'll know that I like to use extremely specialized, complex, and highly technical equipment. And today is no exception. Today, I shall be using this compass and this rock to explain military compass calculations. What else? One day I'll get some specialist, highly technical equipment, but for today, a basic compass and a rock, that's all we need. Now, I'm not looking to explain the full training requirements for anybody in a FOP. I'm just sticking to the very basics: direction, distance, and deviation. The direction to my target, you know, which way do I throw my rock? The distance to my target, how far does my rock have to travel? The deviation, the height deviation, is the target higher or lower than me? It's really simple. Once I've got the direction, distance, and deviation, I should be able to throw my rock at the target with confidence that it will land where I want it to, or at least near enough. Anyway, that's enough chat, let's get started. The first thing to do is we need to use our compass to get the direction to our target so that we know which direction to throw our rock. The target for today, by the way, is the gate that you can hopefully see behind me. I was going to use one of these compasses, but I think I'll use one of these Proster IP65s, which are these. I don't know if you've seen them before. It's a typical, just a standard lens attic compass. The reason for using this is it's the only one I've got, and I have a lot of compasses. This is the only one I've got which has got a tripod mount on it. So I'll be able to put it onto a tripod and you'll be able to see what I'm doing. Depending on the type of compass that you're using, the method for getting a bearing will vary. Some people call a bearing an azimuth. But for this one, all you do, like most lens attic compasses, you line up the target through the notch and to the sighting line there, and then you read the bearing through the lens, which is this little bit at the bottom here. It's quite simple. And in this case, the bearing to the center of the gate is 256. Now, as I'm not going to be putting this bearing onto a map, I'm just going to throw my rock. I don't need to worry about declination because it's irrelevant. If I was going to give that bearing, some people call a bearing an azimuth. If I was going to give that bearing to somebody who was going to use it somehow on a map, then they would need to account for the local declination. So now we have the direction to the target, which in this case is this gate. This has nothing at all to do with compass, military compass calculations, has it? So let's stay focused and cut this waffle out completely. Sorry about all that waffle. I really have to stop that. I really have to stay focused and stay on topic. What was I saying? Oh yeah, now we know the direction to the gate, 256. The next thing we need to know is the distance. How far away is it? Because if we throw our rock on a bearing of 256, is it going to go 100 meters or is it going to go 500 meters? We need to know how far our target is away. And to calculate this, we need two bits of information. We need the angular width and the physical width. The angular width is the angle between the two edges of an object when you look at it. So you would take a compass bearing to the left of the gate and also to the right. And the difference is the angular width in degrees. The physical width is just the real life width of an object measured in meters. For example, most gates in this area are about 3 meters wide to accommodate tractors. And yes, this is England, so there is a rule. There's rules for everything. I don't know why, there just is. If you're bored or curious, you can do a Google on BS5709 2018. Yes, I'm not joking. There are even rules about gates. Anyway, the very basic idea is really simple. The further away an object is, the smaller its angular width that it appears to be, even though the physical width stays the same. I'll give you an example. Imagine a car that is 4 meters long and it's parked sideways to us. If it's parked 20 meters away, the angular width will be, bear with me, sorry, will be 11.3 degrees. So from the back to the front of the car will appear like that. If it was parked 50 meters away, this is the same car, so it's the same physical width, then at 50 meters, it would be 4.5 degrees. Hopefully you understand that. If something is further away, so that's close, but when you look at it further away, from the back to the front is like that, okay? And yes, I know that a lot of people now are thinking of Father Ted. Small cow, far away. If you haven't seen Father Ted, you won't know what I'm talking about. Just one quite important point about accuracy. For distance readings to work, you really should be as perpendicular to the target as you possibly can. That means you're at right angles. At the moment, I'm at right angles to that gate. If I was 50 meters over there, then I would be looking at the gate at an angle. So instead of taking a bearing from here to here, the bearing would actually be smaller when I was viewing it. Hopefully you get that. So, and that would introduce a parallax error. Now there are, once again, military compass calculations that you can use to compensate for not being at right angles to something. But today we're just doing the three basic calculations. I may do another one about parallax errors at a later date, but not today. So the main thing is, if you're taking a bearing from something that you want the distance of, try and be at right angles to that object or target. The formula that we need for today is the distance equals the physical width of an object in meters divided by the tangent of the angular width in degrees. I'll say that again. The distance equals the physical width of an object in meters divided by the tangent of the angular width in degrees. And I know that may sound complicated, and it would be if you had to start calculating Taylor series functions. But today, for this video, we're going to cheat. And we're going to use a standard phone calculator, a mobile phone calculator. You don't need to. If you are comfortable doing Taylor series functions, that's fine. But today, just to speed things up, I'm going to use my mobile phone. Let's do an example together. Have you got your mobile phone? If not, pause the video and go and get your phone. Have you got it? Okay, open the calculator. So it should look something like that. Now, let's assume that we've got an object with a physical width of 5 meters. So it's 5 meters wide. And it's got an angular width of 10 degrees. Switch your calculator over to scientific mode. On an Android, all you do is, there's your phone, just turn it sideways and that's the scientific calculator. On an iPhone, just press scientific. Now you enter the physical width, which don't forget is 5 meters, and then divide tan for tangent, and then add in the angular width, which is 10 degrees, and you should have 28.36 meters. So if we had an object which was 5 meters wide and an angular width of 10 degrees, we would now know that that was 28.35 meters away. Okay, so I've got my two bearings. So now we've said all this, can you work out how far it is from here to that gate? Don't forget, the distance is the physical width of an object in meters divided by the tangent of the angular width in degrees. And in this case, the rules say that the gate must be 3 meters wide. And my compass tells me that the left-hand side of the gate is 254.5 degrees, and the right-hand side of the gate is 257.5 degrees. I'll give you a few minutes to work it out. Pause the video and give it a try. Did you work it out? If you got a distance of 57.2 meters, well done, you're correct. Don't forget, because 3 divided by the tangent of 3 is 57.243. So now we know which direction the gate is, and we know how far away the gate is. The next thing we need is the gate's relative altitude, its deviation in height from where I'm standing. In other words, is it higher or lower than my position? And if so, by how much? If you know the distance to an object, which we do, and the angle from your location to the object, and I can simply use my compass to find out the angle to the object, there's a very simple way to calculate the deviation in height relative to you. Deviation is the distance in meters times the tangent to the angle to the target. I'll say that again. Deviation is the distance in meters times the tangent of the angle to the target. Now, the compass is on a tripod, and I'll estimate the tripod is 1.5 meters above the ground. So I'm going to point the edge of the compass at the top of the gate, which is also about 1.5 meters above the ground. So bear with me. I'll then check on the inclinometer, which tells me the gate is 6 degrees difference, in 6 degrees from above my position. So can you work out how high that gate is? I'll give you a few moments, but first of all, remember the formula. Deviation is just the distance, which, if you remember, we worked out already, 57.24 meters, times the tangent of the angle, which the inclinometer tells me is 6 degrees. So pause the video and see if you can work it out. Did you get it? Did you calculate? Did you arrive at a result of 6 meters higher? If you did, well done, that's correct. So the gate is 6 meters above our position. If it was a minus or a negative figure, don't forget, it would have been lower than our position. That's it for today. We've gone through the basics of direction, distance, and deviation from here to somewhere else, well, the gate. Now, obviously there is lots more that we could talk about, not just in relation to military compass calculations, but any calculations that require information that you get from your compass. But today we're just sticking to direction, distance, and deviation. Otherwise, this video would just last for hours. So thanks for watching.